Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I will show you how to enable SSH on Cisco router OSX. So this is our lab technology and I have a Cisco router 1941 which is connected to this PC through a Cisco switch 2960 and I have assigned 192 and 68 1.1 to this router interface, which is bit 0/0, and 192.168.1.3 to this PC, and I want to SSH this router from this PC. So in order to SSH this router from this PC, I need to configure or enable SSH on this router. So now I'm going to start the configuration. Go to CLI mode of this router. So this is the CLI mode. And in order to enable SSH, we need to first configure the host name. So go to global configuration mode and configure the host name. I'm going to assign my name R1 to this router. You can assign any name. And the next step is to define the domain name. So I'm going to define domain name as demo.com. And the next step is to configure username and password. Because at the time of SSH, we need to use the username and password to authenticate. Okay. So let's configure the username and password. Also configure enable password. And as we know, by default, triple A old model is enabled, so we need to enable triple A new model. Triple A new model. And the next step is to generate SSH key. So the command for that is IP for crypto key generate RSA. And by default the modulus value is 512. So we need to change the modulus value. We can give it as 1024. And as you can see, generating 1024 bit of RSA key. So, and now SSH has been enabled. Okay. And as we have to enable only SSH to this router, not telnet and all. So, for that, we need to go to the line VTY. Line VTY 04. And, transport input SSH and write the configuration. So configuration part has been done and now we have to verify that we are able to SSH this router or not. So go to the PC which is connected to this router. So this is the PC and the command prompt. So I'm going to SSH. So the command to SSH is SSH -L and the username which was admin and IP address of that router, which is 192.168.1.1. So now it is asking for password, and the password is admin. As you can see, we are in user privilege mode. So now I am going to enable the router, and again it is asking for password. So another password was admin, and as you can see, we are able to log in into the router. Now we can do anything like any kind of configuration changes and monitoring also. So we can see the running configuration using current commands. So thanks for watching this video.